In today's video, I'm going to show you how I installed a 32-inch playfield monitor on my Arcade1Up modded pinball machine. Now, this is not a rerun, so if you're familiar with my channel, you may have already seen a previous video in which I did a proof of concept video installing a 32-inch monitor on an Arcade1Up pinball machine. Now, back then, I was trying to connect the existing stock PCB to a larger playfield monitor, and while it did work, it just didn't look good in my opinion, and the monitor I was using, I couldn't even get it in the body of the playfield, and it just sat on top of the sides, and it just really didn't look good in my opinion. This go around though, I was able to resolve a lot of those issues. I was able to get the monitor inside the playfield body without doing any kind of crazy modifications, and now that we've got a PC running inside, we don't have to worry about 720p resolution. We can go as high or as low as we possibly want, run multiple monitors, and everything looks great now. Ultimately, my goal was to get the largest playfield monitor possible inside the stock Arcade1Up body without having to mod or manipulate the body panels itself, as well as make it as stupid easy as I possibly could for anybody that would want to replicate or attempt to do this themselves. Now, you don't have to do 32 inches. You could do a 27-inch monitor. Heck, Dell even makes some very obscure 30-inch monitor that is stupid expensive, but you can do any size monitor you want. However, there's always caveats. Keep in mind, every manufacturer and maker of monitors, well, their sizing is going to be a little bit different, so you may either run into new roadblocks that I didn't experience, or you may have an even easier experience. But either way, I'll put the part and the recommended monitor that I used in the video description box below. Without further ado, let me show you how I got that bad boy in here. All right, let me show you what we got going on here. This is a 32-inch LG computer monitor, 75 hertz. Well priced. I think it was like $140 what I paid for it off of Amazon, so it's pretty good. Fits inside the Arcade1Up body with some modifications. So this monitor specifically is definitely on the COOLTOY diet plan. If there was a monitor bracket, housing, case, everything basically that was on this monitor, I removed. If it was being held on by a screw, it's been taken off. So this thing is completely naked gets for computer monitors. I had to do all that just to get it to fit inside the, you know, the Arcade1Up body itself, because I didn't want to cut the panels and I didn't want to expand anything. I wanted to be able to get the biggest monitor possible inside the Arcade1Up pinball machine. And as you can see, we got the stock 24-inch monitor versus 32. So you gain a lot of size with your play field. But it definitely is some work. And one thing specifically when I did this in the past is a proof of concept. So I used a 32-inch TV in the past and I could not get it inside the body, so to speak. Everything was like sitting on top of the playfield and the body panels, and I just didn't like the look of it. So this is actually inside. It's recessed. It's about as low as you could possibly go. It's basically sitting on top of the existing Arcade1Up playfield monitor frame, as well as down here in the corner. It's resting actually on the top of the nut that goes on for my flipper buttons here. But as you can see, it goes all the way back here. You know, just barely any space over here towards the back. So definitely, like I said, as big as you can possibly get. Now you could do this smaller, you could do like 27 inches, but then you're gonna have to do modifications still, because even with a 27-inch playfield, you'll have to do something with this area right here specifically. But what I've done, I had to remove the cross brace that was going on right here that holds this piece in place. I completely took it out, flipped it over, painted it black, and basically it is right here wedged up into the back of the monitor. And the reason I did that was because, number one, I had to remove the stock back piece that was back here just to be able to get the monitor far enough back inside the cabinet. That way it wasn't cutting off, you know, the top couple of inches of the play field. So I removed the stock backing plate back there, took the front backing plate, flipped it upside down, painted it black, and put it back here. And that solves one of two things. Number one, if I didn't do that after I removed that stock back piece, there would just be this wide open gap here and you'd be able to see through the back of the cabinet and it'd just be ugly. Number two is it has this nice little ledge here that you can put your glass on. What I've done right here is I've actually just got some little foam pieces, and this is what I'm going to be resting my glass on, because one of the problems is, due to the slant of the monitor here,
my glass would have to be different thicknesses, and I obviously don't want to have different thicknesses all the way across. So what I've done is I've just got some felt tabs here, and then I've got those foam tabs up there, and that's going to be what holds my glass in place. And they're at different thicknesses, so everything will be level once I put the glass back in. And here we have the glass installed. It's pretty close to flush. Nice and solid. I got a nice piece of custom glass cut for me by a local glass shop. It took them forever to get it in, but it's well worth it. As far as size and dimensions of the glass to go with this monitor, what I had cut was 16 1/4 inches by 28 3/4 inches, and it was 1/4 inch thick. So this is tempered glass, rolled edges and everything. Not gonna break or anything. This is standard glass. I've still had no issues with it. I know people are freaking out about safety. If you got kids, don't go the cheap Lowe's route. If you got kids, go the tempered route. You'll pay more, but you'll have better peace of mind. I don't have kids and I'm a responsible adult. I'm not smacking the top of my glass. So do whatever you feel is right and necessary for your lifestyle. And as far as, you know, the foam and the installation, things like that, you can do this completely 10 different ways. I just wanted to make this as stupid simple as possible and accessible for as many people out there, because I didn't want it to be to where you had to make a custom bracket or, you know, get out your woodworking tools or anything like that. This is how you could possibly get this particular 32 inch monitor inside the playfield and recessed down here inside the Arcade1Up body without having to do any crazy modifications and, you know, manipulating the existing body panel. Now, one thing to note I also did have to do when I was shoving the monitor inside was I did have to loosen some of the side bolts a little. So namely this one on both sides, as well as ones there in the back, just to loosen them up so the cabinet body could breathe a little bit, but I didn't have to remove the legs or anything. I did that, got the monitor back in there, and then I was able to screw those screws back in there nice and tight. Now everything is holding very steady and very stable and looks great. So inside the cabinet, as I said before, the monitor is just resting on top of the stock existing playfield monitor housing. If you wanted to recess the monitor even further, you could, you know, remove this piece completely and then you'd be able to, you know, recess it just a little bit more. And then the piece that I repurposed from the front and put in here in the back to close that gap so you weren't able to just see through the back of the playfield monitor. Basically, like I said, all I did was paint it, turn it upside down, remove the screws, the wood dowels and everything. And then it is actually just held in place by pressure because it literally just barely fits. Touching the monitor and touching the back support here, it compresses it just enough to keep everything nice and tight. I mean, once you get the chrome trim back on, you are going to crop off just a hair of the bottom of your playfield here, just because that's how far the monitor goes underneath the actual trim, but it is not a whole lot. And for almost all the tables, it's not important what is getting cut off. So just be aware that you will lose just a little bit on the bottom, but you don't lose anything on the sides and you won't lose anything up here on the top. You'll get to see all the playfield in those areas.
Like I said, I'm really excited how this turned out. It was a lot easier than I thought, just a little bit of Boy Scout ingenuity and just throwing things in there. You could do it differently. You can do it better than me, of course. However, this is how I did it, and I hope it's helpful to you. Anyways, if you enjoyed the content, make sure you hit that like button, share this video with your friends if you found the information helpful, and as always, thanks for watching, guys. It really means a lot.